Norman, one of the things that we haven't mentioned in this webinar is the issue of breakout time, which was always used to argue that the JCPOA set back Iran's nuclear program some period of time, a year or more, rather than a potentially very nascent and quickly evolving nuclear program. Some of the explosions that have happened in Iran of late, what's the, in your sense, your assessment of where the setbacks that happened at some of their facilities, has that set back breakout time in any material way? What's your assessment of the impact of those explosions on Iran's breakout time?
Well, that's an important question. So to begin, I want to say I don't know if an outside factor was involved in those explosions, for the record. And without even commenting on that issue, I think the most important takeaway from this is the if indeed an external actor was involved in that explosion, then the most significant impact on the breakout time is actually a decision by Iran's leaders. They have to, in essence, say to themselves, if I build a program, will I be able to build it successfully and take it to execution before an external actor finds out about it and responds, perhaps in a conventional manner? So I think such these actions send a message to Iran's leadership that they can't get away with nefarious activity. Now, this said, the amount of destruction that's been taken that has taken place, Iran has not published. Iran has not let it known what type of systems were involved. Iran generally exaggerates its advanced technologies and focuses on its more proven technologies. So at this point, I think it's easy to say the timeline has been set back. It's likely that Iran's leadership understands that they need to really think carefully about undertaking a nuclear weapons program and thinking they can get away with it. But that doesn't mean that they won't at some point decide to do so. And that maybe is the final line of it. It's set it back. But once again, as long as Iran believes the international community is not unified in compelling constraints on its nuclear program that are meaningful, real, and long-term, the thought will probably remain in the back of the head of at least some of their hardliners that such a nuclear weapons program is possible.